Hey troops, how's it going today? Welcome to the ScareCorp channel. So it's part three of my SnoTek repair. I've been trying to find the part that I need, the fuel shutoff valve, and it's been pretty difficult finding it. I found about 100 others that might work, but they're all different. And they're not too bad. They're for anywhere from $10 to $30, depending on what type you get, the plastic or the metal ones. But then I got to thinking, what if I could fix the one that I have? So I started tinkering with it here, and I thought I might show you what I was up to. So let's take a look. Alright, so I got my drill out, my drill bits, and I actually drilled out the little whatever you call them, little stopper thing, whatever that is called. I don't know. Anyway, it was filled with that little rivet thing, so I drilled it out. Zoom in. There we go, and made these holes here. Then I'm about to try the same thing on this piece. I'm gonna drill out this one and this one, and I found a couple of screws here that might do the trick, that I might be able to put them in here, if you could see. So I kind of have to drill down a little bit, maybe too much. Maybe I'll put it on a little washer or something here if I can find one. Or maybe even just cut off the end of this guy here. Anyway, I got my tap set here. I measured this guy here to about a 0.5. I have two of them, and then I'm gonna, here's my tap set. I'm going to get my 0.5 guy out, and then I might make a hole in a couple of holes in this guy and see how that works, and then maybe with some luck I might be able to put this guy back on here with these couple of screws. Alright, just a quick update. I was able to drill out a couple of holes, one here, and I actually started on the tap, and it's going in pretty good. Let's see if I can show you that. That's kind of what it looks like. So I'm not sure if I drilled it far enough, but if I didn't, I'll just use a little washer or something. So it's actually goes as another half of that once I use the screwdriver here. So wanted to give you a quick update, just to show you what I was doing here, and I'll show you once I'm done this guy as well. Alright, I have to report that I have a little bit of a setback. My tap broke off inside. Mother effer. So you can see, broke, and she's stuck in there. So I don't have another one of that size. It's gonna be a pain in the butt to get that thing out. So I just wanted to show you guys an update and a bit of a setback. So anyway, I'll let you go, and I'll see how I make out. All right, boys and girls, after a few hours of breaking a bunch of bits, I was able to get that thing out. And I do have to say that I kind of made it look ugly. There it is. So, it's actually in there really good. I made it maybe a little bit too tight even. But this thing does turn, and it does look like it will hold. So this side is perfect. It never busted off on me. It's actually holding real well. I had to loosen it just a little bit here, just so it doesn't, so this thing's not so tight. This side I had to come in through the bottom, re-drill it through the top. It was pretty tough going. I broke a bunch of bits. Got her done. We'll see how this works. Not my best job here, but looks like it'll stay. It's holding. It's pretty tight. I will see how this operates. I will show you maybe another clip here. Once this thing's on, and see how it works, and then I'm going to try to fire it up. Not today, though. Today I'm done. I had enough with this thing today, so maybe tomorrow I will install this thing and maybe get some fresh fuel, because I think that was my problem in the beginning, why I didn't want to start. And once I do that, I will show you guys how this thing is running. I'll maybe even show you, make sure it doesn't leak on us. So, all right, I'm done for today. It's been a long day, but I think I got her done. So, that's it for my time. I do thank you for yours.